Hey, what's up? Yo, it's raining. Guess what? I don't care. Yo, Koreans yelling chants, that's crazy. How often does that happen? Anyways, props out to, I didn't even see them earlier, but Workers World is here too. Nice to meet you, yeah, and thanks for showing up, for real, yeah? A lot of people don't recognize Korea's issue as an issue, but you know, it really is. Hell yeah, man.
Oh, yeah.
You're in the mix with djelf7.
What brings you guys here today?
Okay, we want to end the Korean War.
Okay.
And we want the South and North Korea united one.
Okay.
Because we want to be always together.
In New York City, there's some historic firsts like Ron Kim, Linda Lee, Julie Won. These are elected Korean-American firsts.
Okay.
Grace Lee, are any of them here today? Do you know if they're going to support something like this?
I hope so.
I hope so, yeah.
I hope so.
Okay.
Boom, jacket. Hell is going
to go get the Olympics. Yeah.
I came here from
Central New Jersey.
Oh, yeah.
It just took you 2 hours to come here.
All right, cool, man. Call for peace in Korea, end the Korean War, and stop the Biden administration, the U.S. government, for its aggressive actions in Korea.
Land of liberation, I know this guy.
Cool, man.
Keep it up, man. All right. One love. Thank you. Riley, what's up, man? Yo, you got my message on Instagram?
Surprise, motherfucker.
Oh, you did?
Oh,
no? Yo, it's L7, man. You should talk sometime, man. Hit me up. This is my card, all right? This is Riley Park. You can't mistake him, yeah? Hit me up sometime, all right? Don't listen to what they say, man. All right? One love, brother. We'll see. All right, good luck, okay? Good luck.
It was a call for democratization. Citizens demanded the military step down and lift the emergency martial law. The reply, deadly force. The events that unfolded in Gwangju on May 18, 1980 have long been labeled a riot. Efforts to shed light on the truth only began after the military junta bowed out.
아주 그냥 지축을 울리는 그런 그 기관 총소리가 두두두두두 세 번 더.
There's no question that he is and was greatly reviled both during his time in office and after it. But bear in mind that this is a man who took power in a coup d'etat in 1979-1980, which was a time when South Koreans believed they were truly ready for democracy. They were starting to gain some prosperity, some political sophistication, and during this Seoul Spring, there was a belief that the country was on the right track. Chun Chun-won, this general, this Vietnam veteran, then came onto the scene and in a sort of creeping coup d'etat, he took over power in 1980. There were massive protests against what he was doing. This was not a popular move at all. And those were suppressed in Seoul and other cities. But
will you all join in a toast? Celebrating the never-ending friendship of two nations and toasting the President of the Republic of Korea, President Chun and Madam Chun.
The time has come for America to hear the truth about this tragic war. The hottest places in hell are reserved for those who, in a period of moral crisis, maintain their neutrality. There comes a time when silence is betrayal. Truth of these words is beyond doubt, nor does a human spirit move without great difficulty. Against all the apathy of conformist thoughts within one's own bosom.
There's no better proof of the relationship between strength and freedom than right here in the DMZ in Korea. You are on the front lines of freedom, and I want each of you to know but I bring you warm greetings from your family and your friends back in the States. You stand between the free world and the armed forces of a system that is hostile to everything we believe in as Americans.
As a Democratic government took office, the tombs of those who were killed during the pro-democracy movement were designated a national cemetery, and the victims were decorated as heroes. But this came with a message of forgiveness and leaving the task of unveiling the truth to history. But the word forgiveness rang hollow. There was no one apologizing or reflecting on the past wrongdoing regarding the question of who gave the military the order to fire at citizens. Efforts have resumed to find the truth and punish those responsible for the tragedy. Hopefully, results may materialize this time around. Still, the past four decades remains a painful part of Korean history.
We know about the danger. You're facing a heavily armed, unpredictable enemy with no record for, or regard, I should say, for human life.
They are often the kinds of kids that are called super predators. No conscience, no empathy. We can talk about why they ended up that way, but first we have to bring them to heel.
Recently, as you know, we sent our forces to the island of Grenada. Some critics compared that operation with the Soviet invasion of Afghanistan. Well, let me just say, there's something seriously wrong with anyone who can't see the difference between 100,000 Soviets.
Well, you didn't think I forgot about you.
Word. BS. Why they gotta say it like short? BS. You know they can't play on my court. Can't hang with the big dogs. Stay on the porch. Blow the whistle. Blow the whistle.
No.
Blow the whistle. Blow the whistle. Oh, where you get that from? Grab a mic, spit one. Let me hit that blind. Pimp C8.
Can we get a motherfucking moment of silence for this small chronic break? Hey, Daz, give me a light, nigga.
Check. The same old slave master today has Negroes who are nothing but modern Uncle Toms, 20th century Uncle Toms, to keep you and me in check, keep us under control, keep us passive and peaceful and non-violent. That's Tom making you non-violent. It's like when you go to the dentist and the man is going to take your tooth. You're going to bite him when he starts pulling. So they squirt some stuff in your jaw called Novocaine to make you think they're not doing anything to you. So you sit there and because you got all that Novocaine in your jaw, you suffer peacefully.
And so I wanted to express my support and solidarity with the people of Israel. And that tweet was criticized for being unmindful of the context, the history.
Yo, it's your boy Rafi, that's all. Okay, and what do you have to say to the Yang Gang people?
I'm not really fond of them.
But weren't you like the Queen's coordinator?
Yep.
Yo, our people served you, Yang, and you throwing us in the trash? What's wrong with you, man? What's wrong with, how could you, right, you served Yang loyally, and what did he do, man?
He just backstabbed me, man.
Did he ever even, was he even willing to even have a conversation?
No, not really.
That's what Yang is, right? Yeah, if you are suffering, but you're not convenient, he'll just throw you in the trash and not listen to you. I joined Yang's group to be part of the solution, not the problem.
Can I talk to John? Yeah? I can't, right? Yeah? John, you got a moment for a brother? Come on, man. John. They don't like me talking loud. You come here, I'll talk quiet. We could talk about these issues I've been emailing you about. We could talk about those emails, those things I've been emailing you for months about. John, I'm a fan of yours. I'll be real. You're a pioneer for Asian Americans. But John, you're leaving a lot of Asian Americans behind. You're only taking care of the problems of people that matter, not me. John, why are you only talking to pretty ladies? You got time for a brother like me? What if I'm a victim too? John, I'm a victim. Doesn't my actions seem consistent with the victim who's struggling for justice? No justice, no peace, you know the words. Come on, John, you could talk to me. Why isn't John talking to me? He can't talk, that's because, you know why? Because I would let him talk. All John's gotta do is come here and talk to me, but he won't, right? Because he knows that I'm gonna show the pages of emails that I sent his office, the pages of emails that I sent to Linda Lee, the pages, and they know that there's a command to not talk. Bye, John. Bye, John. Hey, John, look, man. I'm a victim. I need your help, man. I thought you were gonna help people. Why are you cycling away? John, he's leaving. John, he's leaving. That's right. They say they're gonna help you. Look at how they're helping me.
And making sure that everybody has the help and support that they need. And we, as a federation, are very happy and proud to stand in this line of work with the Korean American Family Services Center. I also want to take a moment to talk from a personal point of view. Thank you, Assemblymember Jessica Gonzalez-Rojas, as well as Councilmember Sandra Ong, for opening this space up to talk about your personal experiences. Without groups like Korean American Family Services Center, we would not be able to have this kind of conversation. And as somebody that
if they talk to me,
has
Niagara,
also been
So what have they actually done to help your cause, your poverty, your problem? They're your friends. I know they're your friends. That's why you're backing them up. But I'm asking for rationality and justice. I eventually asked why they kicked me off that stage, but we all know why. To protect their corrupt-ass little fucking bullshit friends. I know about that because you want to be friends with the sexy people, the connected people, the people that matter, not me. Why does my voice not matter today? Because you don't give a shit. Yeah, yo, you laugh, this guy's laughing. Look at that, who's a victim of war? Me. But he laughing at me because my voice don't matter. Yeah, they just want to exploit your people for your political power. I swear to you, if they gave a shit about this racist shit, they would have time for me, Shirley. You know me because you know I've been out here for years. People understand the oppression and the disregard. These white people won't know till the black people tell them. Yeah, they won't know till the black people tell them because they've been so programmed. They do. Black people suffer from this shit too. That's why they recognize it. Thank you.
And the hair is just about NATO and white shit. Get the fuck out of here.
Come on, man. Have you
just
even know about my work?
Into the new year in Cambridge,
no?
Massachusetts.
What you want to find out? If you want to listen to other Asian men or you listen to white men?
A 20-year-old. So,
who do you think is more against the war? Who do you think suffered more from the war? Me or this motherfucker right up here? Tell me the fucking truth, man. You don't know, right? Yeah, you've been programmed by the white man.
Oh, what's up, man? I remember you.
Oh, hey!
This time? Are we cool this time? Oh, my God. What's the problem? I'm Korean, you know that? I don't know about you, man. Okay, whatever, man. Look, I ain't got a problem with you. It's up to you, bro. Oh, he running away, too. Run away, bro, run away. So, are you Korean, by the way?
No, I'm
not. Oh, what? Okay, where are you from?
I'm Japan.
Oh my God, holy. I'm feeling so I get that,
I've
wow.
I've been participating in these rallies over a few years.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay. There's a lot of Koreans in Japan, maybe?
Yes.
You think, are you Korean Japan, or?
No, I
you're
am
just
not.
Straight Japanese?
I don't know if it's straight or twisted, but.
That's quite an interesting story. Okay, well, nice to meet you. So, what brought you? You believe in a reunified Korea. I do see some. What do you think the relationship is between Korea, the U.S., and Japan?
I think Japanese
American.
Often tend to forget that they are in the Asia, and then Korea and Japan are very close, like geographically, very, very close. Very close relationship, historically very close relationship. We learned a lot of stuff from Korean people.
It's good and bad. There's a controversial past, but good and bad.
Yes.
So, I appreciate Japanese people.
So we kind of try to forget that we are Asian, and try to follow the U.S.
Yeah, that's true. We should work together. Yeah.
We should work together, and so it's very complicated because the mass media are more like pro-U.S.
Hey, quick question for you. Now in Korea, what they do is they have U.S. military bases there, and they try to make Korea pay for it. Do they do the same thing in Japan?
Yeah, of course. It's been a long time, and then Japanese governments are paying a lot of money, and
they have U.S. bases there.
Of course, there are many bases.
I'm sorry, I didn't know. Yeah.
Oh no, many bases. Yes, and then actually, I am against U.S. military bases, not only U.S. but military bases, especially in Okinawa. Okinawa is a small island, but it's heavily occupied by the military.
Yeah.
If you ever gone to Okinawa, you'd be really amazed if you just drive to
I think Japanese are powerful allies with us, and honestly, we're going through a lot of the same problems right now with the population and stuff. We gotta start working together. I know it's been, you know, it's controversial history, but, you know, she's saying some real stuff, so thank you so much. Yeah? And shout out to the Japanese people. That's that was unexpected, but hey, that's awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, I really, really thank you.
Thank you.
The standing of this whole reunification thing.
I guess this is more war in Korea happening between, I'm assuming,
okay.
I'm not really sure.
You know,
my only question is,
go ahead.
Why are there so few people in this who are not Korean American?
This is a recurring theme. If you take a look at, like, remember there was starvation in North Korea, very similar to Ethiopia, but there wasn't really the same amount of press. They've been actually, if you take a look at the Vietnam War, what stopped the Vietnam War? The pictures of the suffering.
Right.
Now you can't even find that on YouTube. It's blocked by the algorithm, and also they don't show the pictures of suffering anymore. The same thing's true for Palestine and other countries like that. Are you from New York City or New Jersey? You're from New York City?
Brooklyn.
Oh, cool. Okay, so I don't know if you ever heard of someone named Grace Lee, Ron Kim.
Yeah, I know that.
So have they spoken out on this issue?
They, I don't think they have that issue exactly, but probably they also,
what are they waiting for?
Yeah.
It would be nice. Okay, so look, I'm not, I don't want to give you guys a hard time, but we're waiting. Come on, guys. Yeah, all right. Historical Korean-American firsts. It's your time to step up for
that's
us.
That's true, that's true.
It has, that war had nothing to do with our people, right? Yeah, it was the U.S. and USSR. They want to have their little fight. Yeah, the Koreans were not fighting each other, okay?
Do you
we were
hear
fine.
About the Korean president?
Oh, yeah, the singing the thing?
Yeah,
yeah.
He came here
pretty
and,
sad.
Yeah, show us to all of the world people stupidity of Korea. that's why we are,
You know what?
Yeah.
Ever since the Gwangju Uprising, look
that's
it up,
true, that's true.
It's been a U.S. puppet. It's been a puppet. Every single Korean president been in jail. Come on, okay? We all know what the deal is. So that's why he's there singing American Pie, because honestly, that's the U.S., that's the government right there. It's a puppet. I'm sorry. Yeah, we all know it. We all know, all right?
Yeah,
thank
that's
you.
Right, yeah. That's yeah. why we are just for that, yeah.
Thank you, brother. That's pretty. Oh snap! That's right. Let's.
I don't know what God gossip about consensual things that happen between me and one person have to do with this rally. I really don't. I really don't know what gossip about me and consensual things that happen with one person have to do with this rally. Based on the fact that something consensual happened with me between one person, she basically called every member of CPI a sexual predator in that email. Some consensual truth and suggestion.
Sometimes it means being frustrated.
Caleb Maupin is a journalist and political analyst based in New York City. He has reported extensively from the Middle East and Latin America and has made frequent appearances on RT and Press TV. He's also the founder and director of the Center for Political Innovation. And his book is called Bread Tube Serves Imperialism, Examining the New Brand of Internet Pseudo-Socialism. There it is. And it's all about your favorite YouTubers.
A genuine revolution of values means in the final analysis that our loyalties must become ecumenical rather than sectional. Every nation must now develop an overriding loyalty to mankind as a whole in order to preserve the best in their individual societies. This call for a worldwide fellowship. Let me say finally that I oppose the war because I love America. And above all, with a passionate desire to see our beloved country stand as the moral example of the world. I speak out against this war because I'm disappointed with America. And there can be no great disappointment where there is no great love. It is time for all people of conscience to call upon America. Come back home. Come home, America. I call on Washington today. I call on every man and woman of goodwill all over America today. I call on the young men of America who must make a choice today. Take a stand on this issue.